my name is Dr. Leo Yvonne Alcorn. I'm a postdoctoral researcher here at University of Toronto and a wannabe space-hopping witch like Keziah Mason in Dreams in the Witch House by H.P. Lovecraft. Cosmic horror is a literary genre that assumes certain things about the universe, such as mankind's ultimate unimportance in the universe, and that we're unequipped to be able to understand all of the internal workings of the universe. This is the base assumption of cosmic horror. It's also called Lovecraftian horror because it was developed by H.P. Lovecraft. But it's evolved beyond Lovecraft and become its own genre entirely in horror and science fiction. An important thing about Lovecraftian horror is that it assumes a naturalistic universe. There's nothing supernatural about it. For example, the gods, the great old ones, or the elder gods, referred to in the works of cosmic horror, are actually not gods or anything supernatural. They're simply aliens who live much longer than we do, who understand the universe at a level that we simply do not have. Additionally, humans in these works are oftentimes academics, like me. So oftentimes I find that I can relate to these stories. But these humans are also quite fragile in their mental states. And when they see the truth of the universe, they oftentimes go mad. Let's hope that doesn't happen to us. I love Lovecraftian horror because it assumes something very similar to what we assume when we do cosmology as scientists, that we are not special, that we are limited. And I find that to be actually very motivational. Not only are the stories seen in Lovecraftian or cosmic horror very scary, they assume a naturalistic universe that we simply just don't understand. And to be honest with you, I feel very similarly sometimes about science. I find it very hard to understand, but that's why I do it. When I was an undergrad, I started reading H.P. Lovecraft, and that was when I started studying astronomy as well. As I was reading through some of these stories, I noticed that there were narrative elements very similar to what I was actually studying in my classes. For example, I read Dreams in the Witch House, my favorite Lovecraft story, and it's all about a witch who is actually using very advanced mathematics and physics to travel through the universe, to create her own wormholes, travel through hyperspace. Additionally, Lovecraft himself was a bit of an astronomy fan, and he used elements of science that was being developed in the time, say quantum mechanics, as story elements. If you read The Color Out of Space, you see that the scientists take a spectrum of this object that has fallen from space and that is not understandable. But this spectrum was used to determine its elemental composition, which of course was unclear. Ooh. My current research is structured around a big central galaxy at the center of a galaxy cluster. Brightest cluster galaxies are very different from something like the Milky Way. In a way, they're almost alien to anything we could understand. These are some of the most massive galaxies in the universe because they're constantly interacting with the gas inside of a galaxy cluster, with small galaxies that fall into a galaxy cluster. Its black holes are very active. As things fall into them, they erupt and emit bubbles of gas into the super hot plasma, creating holes in this gas. There's so much odd things going on. The galaxy cluster that I'm studying right now is called Abel 2390. It's located at 3 billion light years away. That means that we're looking at light from 3 billion years ago. Just to give you some perspective on that, this light was emitted before the dinosaurs, before any life was around on Earth. This is such an alien, unusual environment. How can I, as a simple ape who just thinks too much and is riddled with anxiety, just like all of the academics in Lovecraft's works, understand such an alien and unknowable topic as galaxy clusters. Well, I guess that's the difference between a Lovecraftian protagonist and a real scientist, am I right? So, in both astronomy and cosmic horror, we assume that humans are small and don't really understand what's going on. And I actually agree with this, but despite it making me feel small, it actually offers a glimmer of hope for me. But that's because I'm a scientist. If there's things that I don't understand, that's just an opportunity for more and more research, for more and more curiosity. So, when you look at something like the vast, seemingly unknowable universe, you can either fall over in existential dread and think, woe is me for being so small, or you can think like a scientist and think, this is an opportunity. I may be small, but I can ask questions. I may not be able to get all of the answers to these questions, but it's sure worth a try, isn't it?